What's up, everybody? I got Xolace and Acorn on this new episode of the podcast, the Xat Podcast. I've been talking to these guys on and off. I think we were supposed to do the podcast a couple of days ago. Just kept delaying. What's going on? How you guys doing?
Good. I'm good,
buddy. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. You know, it's July 4th. So I'm going to be going out tonight. How's your holiday going?
You know,
got
a little sunburn from the water park, but otherwise we're good.
Okay, that's pretty cool. All right, you know what? I'm just going to get right into it. So I'm just going to go right into this shit. You guys, how long you guys known each other for?
We've known each other for probably about a little bit over 7 years. And we've been together for about 6.5.
How did you
6.5 years
to meet? Like, how did you guys first meet? Like, was it on Xat?
Taylor PC'd me and he asked me to Skype him.
Okay. And this was all on Xat?
Yeah. I don't know what made him PC me, but I know that's my perception of it, is he PC'd me and he asked him to Skype him with Ivar.
Yeah, so I was in a VC with Ivar the Boneless, and I was just checking out the grid. It was on some chat called Anime Pet Shop, and I was on the grid, and I saw her, and I was like, she's pretty cute. And I asked Ivar if he knew her. He said he knew her a little bit. So I was like, all right, well, let's get her on the Skype call, because I used to have these big Skype parties that I would get together with like 10, 20 people in them. And I just added her on Skype, and Ivar left about an hour or two later in the Skype call, and, you know, me and Gabby, Acorn, we were just, we stayed up all night talking, and from there, dude, I mean, the rest is just history at that point.
Like, okay, because, you know, it's not normal, like, for me to see, like, people dating on Xat and actually beating each other in real life. It's like, not a common thing, because there's a lot of trolls and a lot of fucking shit going on Xat all the time, and you know that, I know that. So... like, you guys have been together for 6-7 years, and how'd you guys manage, like, to stay together for that long?
Well, if you ask me from my perspective, you know, me and Gabby, we both go through broken households and, you know, broken families and that. So for the both of us, it's kind of like we both have, like, attachment and dependency issues on each other. So, you know, I mean... you know, and everyone that's listened to this will know, you know, me and Gabby, we fight a bunch and, you know, we have our arguments. But, you know, I mean, we love each other. We love each other to death. So, I mean, whenever you get that, you know, level of attachment and a level of commitment to one another, I just think, you know, it's easy to, you know, break up with someone. You know, it's easy to turn your back on someone and say, you know, all right, well, you know, this isn't right for one of another, or I mean, you can build and you can try to be better people every single day to work towards, you know, just being a better person, you know, being a better lover, you know, being a better husband or wife or, you know, boyfriend or girlfriend. You know, I mean, if you ask, if you ask those old people who, you know, been together for so long, you know, I mean, they've gone through shit, a lot of shit. And, you know, I think especially in, you know, the younger generation and, you know, our generation, people are just so quick to, you know, get up and leave one another and, you know, start new relationships.
I agree with that. I was going to say that whole thing about, like, if I ask any old person that I know what their secret is to being together for so long, it's not running away the second things start getting tough. So I definitely agree with that.
So, like, you guys been together for 6-7 years. Like, you guys ever think about starting a family, getting married, and like taking it to the next level? I mean, I don't mean to go too personal, but I'm asking this because since you guys met each other on Xat, and, you know, like, so I just thought that, you know, it's pretty cool to see somebody from Xat, you know, being together for so long. Like, are they going to go move on, like, to the next level, you know, where they just want to get settled and, you know, like, you guys think about that? You know, having your own family, marriage, and shit like that.
I mean,
if I'm going too personal, like, you don't have to answer. You don't want to answer.
Oh, no, it's cool. I would say for me, the reason that we haven't gotten married yet, besides all of like the personal issues and like the fighting that we still work through and the emotional issues that we're working on. And like, I know I'm in therapy and Taylor's in therapy, and just besides being healthy people for each other, a lot of it's stability too. Like, I'm still in school for another year and a half and Taylor just started a new job. So to like get engaged and to get married and to start a family and to buy a house and to take all of those steps rather than rush into them and, you know, not be able to afford to do it right, I'd rather take my time, work on myself emotionally, work on everything financially, and I'd rather wait another couple of years before making a major step like that and being able to, you know, do it right versus, you know, just getting married for the sake of saying we're married.
Right, right. I actually, you know, I just think it's pretty cool and interesting, like, somebody being together. It, like, seems like you guys really worked out together and you guys are happy together, because if you've been together for that long, you guys, you know, definitely seem happy couple. Now, I got a question for Xolace, and I'm really going to straight up ask you, why did you try it overdosing the other night, and you posted a photo, a handful of pills, and you were really upset, and everybody in the server was upset online, and it's not something you do. So why did you decide to take a handful of pills? Why overdose? I forgot what it was. What was going on with you, man?
So I knew something was off, dude. Like, I can just get like these vibes and feelings that, you know, something isn't right. And you know, I struggle with bipolar type 1. And like, I'll have these moments of like pure mania where, you know, I'm either I'm either spazzing the fuck out, or like, you know, I'm just like chill and relax, like how I have been today. But you know, dude, you can just kind of like tell when something's off, and you know, the vibes are off on a certain situation, or, you know, you just know something's wrong. And I was like kind of like having those vibes all day long. So like, I went through like this spiraling mania depressive episode, to where, you know, I started to feel suicidal. And, you know, that wasn't like, you know, my first attempt, or, you know, it wasn't something that's like out of the normal, it wasn't uncommon for me to, you know, feel those feelings that I was feeling, or, you know, having those types of thoughts. And that's something I'm also trying to work on, dude. But, you know, I can't really tell my therapist everything about, you know, oh shit, like, you know, I was suicidal on this day, or, you know, I feel this type of way, because all that's going to do is just get me, it's just going to get me locked up into a mental institution. And I really don't want to go there.
Right, right.
So, I hope that answers the question, bud, but, you know, I don't want to throw too much dirt out there, but, you know, later on that night, you know, when you put me in that group chat, it was, you know, it was you, Brendo, Nisa, and a few other people.
Nick.
And Nick, he was in there too. You know, that's when I had, I mean, that was a fresh wound where I just found out that, you know, Gabby had been talking to that guy, Alpha. And that's when, right. I got his information, you know, I scared him away, I guess. But, you know, I still haven't gotten a lot of closure on that yet. Though?
I wasn't talking to him that night, so that can't be an excuse for your mania, because when me and him talked, it was weeks prior. It's just you found out about it that night, and you went off, and you went manic before hearing the full story and came to your own conclusions, and you do that quite a bit. A lot of people know that you kind of go off the rails before, you know the full story, and you kind of go manic. So just to clarify, there was nothing to go upset about.
Well, you know, to kind of clarify what she was saying, you know, I had been told that, you know, two or three nights before I had even found out, I can't remember what day it was, but they were texting that night and already deleting like the messages on Discord and, you know, clearing the text conversations. And, you know, I had been told two or three nights before that night that I had, you know, grabbed his phone number and, you know, got his name and address and shit. was that, you know, I had talked to Gabby, you know, two or three nights before, and, you know, Alpha had told me he had rejected her. And I don't know if that's true or not, because, I mean, I was pretty much like telling him, oh, well, you know, I want to see these screenshots, because it's all he say, she say. He's telling me one thing and then she's telling me another thing. So it's like a who do I believe type of thing, because no one can provide any kind of, you know, proof or evidence. But that goes back to what I was saying earlier, is that, you know, with Gabby specifically, is, you know, I can tell when something is not right or something is off, because earlier that day when I had woken up and I had gone to work, I had seen that, you know, she was on Discord at like 2 or 3 o'clock in the morning. And as far as I had known, she had fallen asleep with me that night. You know, we were cuddling.
I got up and got some water and checked Discord.
Right. You know, look, I'm not a, like a couple therapist or anything, but from what I see is that I feel that Xolace cares about you, and he, you know, he doesn't want to lose you. He really loves you. I can tell, and I can say this because I remember, I think a couple of weeks or maybe months back, I remember Xolace, you DM'd me and you said that, I think you got into a fight at a bar or something. Like I think you hit a guy or hurt somebody because he was disrespecting Acorn. You remember that when you sent me that DM?
Yeah. So what had happened there was I had just gotten off of work, and my weed dealer, he wanted to meet me at some like fucking dive bar. And Gabby came along with me, and I had like two or three drinks in me by this point. And she had told me, like, when we had gotten back into the car, she was like, oh, do you remember that guy? And like she described him, and I was like, yeah. And she was like, yeah, he was like whispering stuff in my ear, like, oh, I want to take you home, and like you know, just a bunch of disrespectful stuff, especially knowing, you know, that's my girlfriend. So she was like freaking the fuck out of me in the car, saying, oh, you never protect me, you never like defend me and this and that. But like she had never told me, like while we were in the bar, like when he like walked away, oh, he said this and this about me.
I thought you heard.
So what had happened then, buddy, Altair, was I dropped her off back off at the house, and the bar is only like a 5-minute drive away from the house, if that. So I had dropped her off, and like I was pissed off because Gabby was saying like cruel things to me about like how like I'm not a man and how like I never defend her. But whenever she had told me, she was like, oh, you know, you're not a man. That's when I had, I dropped her off at the house. And then I went back to the bar. And I mean, I just walked in fucking guns blazing. Like I went to the dude and like I fucking pushed him. And I was like, I can't remember like the whole story, but me and him, like we were like yelling at each other. And then I hit him in the fucking face. I just punched him in his fucking face. And he like went on his ass. I don't know if I knocked him out or not. But then the bar owner came in. He was like, get the fuck out. I'm calling the cops. But nothing ever came of that. Like, the dude never pressed charges. Like, you know, the cops never came to me or found me or anything.
Right, right. I mean, you're lucky. You know, there was no police involved. And so it would have been bad. So, you know, I can tell that you care a lot for Acorn. I get it. I see it. But, dude, you know, like, that really scared the shit out of me when you posted a photo with a handful of pills. I don't know what they were, but I didn't know what to do. I'm like, okay. I didn't know what to do. I'm like, who should I reach out to? This guy's, you know, and I talked to, what's his name? Virology. Viru, like, he just, I don't think he really cared. He said, you know, so the people that I thought that really were mature were like Brando, you know, maybe Nick. I don't know if he's mature, but on Nisa, the other one, she mentioned that you guys know each other for 13 years online. And how's your relationship with Nisa? Like, you guys are close? Do you guys talk outside of Xat?
So me and Nisa, we were supposed to meet before me and Gabby got together. And we were supposed to go to a concert. And I kind of bailed out on her because that was when me and Gabby, you know, we started taking things a lot more serious. And I'm not saying that in a way of like, oh, Nisa and me wanted to go to a concert and like, you know, have sex or like hook up or anything like that, because Nisa's like always been, you know, like my big sister. that I've always gone to, right, with like a bunch of my problems and shit. So there's no like any kind of like emotional investment or attachment there. But beyond that, I mean, I've never met Nisa. She lives relatively close to me, I think, like maybe like a 5 or 6 hour drive. But we've never met just because, you know, she's going through her own things with her boyfriend, Dakota. And I mean, there, it has like a right opportunity has never presented itself for me and Nisa to ever meet. But Nisa was there for me, you know, when like I was talking to Maddie, because her and Maddie got like real, real close as well. And she knows Maddie. So like I was talking to Nisa.
When you say Maddie, do you mean
the girl?
When you say Maddie, you mean Gotti, right?
No, not Gotti. I mean short another name. Maddie. Yeah, okay. her name on Xat is M-A-D-I. It's not Gotti.
Yeah, I'm not sure what that is. I don't know. You have a really good relationship with Nisa, like a friendship, and she, you know, I see you respect her and she respects you. I spoke to Nisa on Tiny Chat. I was really down and depressed because, you know, when you stop taking opioids and a lot of shit happens. So I got on Xat, and you know, Nisa was there and I spoke with her. She seems like a real sweetheart. She's amazing to talk to. So you know Nisa for 13 years. You guys were going to hang out. And so I invited her to that group, dude, when that whole thing happened, because like, you know, I don't like seeing people down and depressed. You know, I don't like seeing people, you know, they're going to do something, you know, because you have people who care about you. You know, you got like, you know, Acorn, she cares about you. I'm sure you got others in your around you that care about you, you know. So I don't like seeing that when people are like, I'm going to do this, you know, I'm upset, so I'm going to do this. You know, it scares the shit out of me sometimes, man, because I'm going through the same struggles. So I got personal problems of mine with me, my fam. I don't want to go too much into details. But I hate seeing people when they do that, you know. You know, I hope you don't do it again. So, you know.
Well, you know, dude, just to clarify, like, I don't do that shit for, like, attention, or I don't do that thing. I don't do that shit because, like,
no, I can tell.
To, like, care
I,
for
I,
me.
I could
I
tell.
Do that shit because that's genuinely how I feel, like, in the moment of, like, my mania. Like, I, like it's a lot deeper than, like, surface-level shit. It's, like, you know, I feel like I work, and I've been working, you know, almost my entire life. And I've gone through so much like trauma in my personal life, you know, ever since I've been a kid. And then, you know, the trauma starts to carry over into your adulthood and it doesn't seem like things are ever going to get any better. And I mean, I'm not even going to lie to you, dude, like waking up every morning is like a fucking chore almost, you know. So like, I don't do that shit. I just want to clarify for anyone listening, like I don't do that shit for attention. I don't give a fuck if you like me, if you don't like me. Like, I don't do it for attention. I do it because, like sometimes I get, like, really, really close to, like, killing myself. And the last time before that was actually on my birthday. And, I mean, I hope it doesn't happen again. And I hope, like, my mania doesn't, like, over-control, like, you know, my emotions like that. And, like, I feel like I want to be suicidal. But, you know, they're, like... There is times when I do it and it's like not like a cry for help or like a cry for anyone to like want to talk to me or nothing, because I get really tired of like, you know, talking to people about, you know, all my problems and shit. So I'm pretty much like a closed book when it comes to that. Unless like, you know me, like I know Chris. Chris knows me really well because me and Chris used to be good friends. Gay Chris and
people. Is gay Chris actually gay by any chance? Just want to clarify that, because I don't know if he's gay or not. I mean, like, because
Chris is gay.
Okay, so we're clear he's gay, because I don't know, sometimes he says he's not. I don't know. Okay, all right, look, Xolace, look, man, I'm glad that you're self-aware, you know what's wrong. I hope, but the thing is, you know, like, I hope that it doesn't happen again. I hope you'd speak to somebody, whether it's me, Acorn, anybody, dude. And like, that should really freak me. Like, you had a handful of pills. You actually messaged me. I don't know if you messaged anybody else. And I'm like, I don't know what to do. I'm trying to talk to urology. I'm like, yeah, bro, this guy's really upset. Let's talk to him. You know, let's just forget about all the bullshit on Xat for a minute. Let's just speak to this guy. So I didn't think he didn't really care. But I think Lisa was probably the one who actually was, she really cared about you. She was really upset and worried. So I was so glad to have Lisa in that group. And she seems to really care about you. And I'm glad you're doing better now. I hope it doesn't happen again. But, you know, you should definitely think about the people around you that care for you, people that love you. Because I know how it is, man. I've been there. So, but, you know, I hope it goes well, dude. So, I mean, this isn't really an interview because, like, I didn't write down anything like what I'm going to ask, basically. It's just a discussion on this podcast because it's pretty interesting. Like I said, I'm talking to you two. You guys met each other on Xat, and now you guys been together for so many years in real life. Like, that's pretty cool because I don't see anything like that on Xat. You know, all I see is a bunch of trolls and people arguing and some stupid shit. I troll too, by the way. I know I see stupid shit. I know you do too. So, so Xolace, moving on. You know, what are talk about your experience on Flirt Chat. You know, so I see you there a lot. You're on there a lot.
So I haven't really been getting on Flirt that long. Like, I've been on Xat for a while. I started off on a chat called Singles Only. And that was on, I found that on a MySpace page when I was like 8 or 9 years old. And then I started going to like WWE chats because I was like really big into WWE when I was like a kid and like a teenager. And then after, you know, that.
Yeah, memory lane has died. Lane has a chat, like a wrestling chat. I don't know if you hang out there.
No, I don't. I don't watch wrestling anymore. But I would like usually pop, like from time to time, I would pop my head into Flirt. And, you know, you'd see guys like, I don't know if you remember him, but like Osama. And then you had, you know, the trolls like Chucky.
Is he,
and Purple Haze.
Is he the guy? Hold on. Pause. Is he the guy one with who was dating, I don't know how to say her name, this girl. Malum, was it? I don't know how you say her name. Was that girl, Malum, whatever. Malum. If you don't know what I'm talking about.
I know who you're talking about. I never really got involved.
That's the guy.
Okay. Go ahead, buddy.
Because they were together, Osama and Malum, whatever, from Flirt. And I think they were dating in real life, too. So they disappeared. Yeah. No, go ahead, dude. You know, we were saying something.
I never really got too deeply involved in, like, the Flirt or, you know, JBZ politics. I would go into JBZ from time to time because I've known Mitch. I actually met Mitch on the WWE chat, and then Mitch started going to JBZ. So I'd go there from time to time, and I'd hang out there. I was never a part of like any kind of like, Xat gang, like Xat Most Wanted or, you know, IDOT. I was never involved in like any of the politics behind it. But I would like go in time to time and, you know, just hang out and talk to people. I would never like try, you know, show my ass or anything. But then after that, I started going into
Xolace, dude, I got a question that I really want to ask you. So I'm just going to be straight up. Are you gay, dude? Or are you? All right, I might edit that out.
No, I mean,
because I've been seeing you post a lot of weird shit in NSFW, dude. So I just wanted to know that if you were gay or not. So
yeah, he's into tranny porn. He likes to be pegged.
So let me clear the air now. That's not true. I've never had anything up my ass ever in my life. I don't know if you'd want to call it gay. I don't really consider it gay because, you know, at the end of the day, it's a woman. But yeah, I mean, I like women only. But I mean, if a chick has a fucking cock, I mean, I'm not going to like discriminate or, you know, and like the attraction cycle there, I guess, if that makes sense.
So, okay. But you identify as straight, dude.
Right? Yeah, I identify straight. Okay.
How do you feel about that Acorn that he's into training videos and he watches that shit? Like, how do you feel about that? How does it?
I think he's in the closet. I think that this is a gateway for him to express his sexuality without feeling judgment. And I think that he's low-key into dudes. And I don't shame him for that. And I'm not one to out someone. So right. If he doesn't want to acknowledge it, then I won't press him further on it.
Right. Because I've seen a lot of shit that he was sharing. Was like, I'm like, what the fuck, dude? You know, whatever. So, Acorn, I want to ask you, so is Xolace was the only guy you ever dated on Xat? Like, anybody else, or is just the only one?
I dated Armin, unfortunately, for a
Armin,
little bit.
That sounds familiar. God, is that the guy from, the guy who does spamming and the flirt all the time with his bots?
Yeah, that's him.
Okay, yeah, that guy.
He's dating my ex-best friend, Marie, now.
Marie, okay, the cutie. I think I was trying to flirt with her. Just blocked me.
No, I don't think Marie is cutie, dude. I think you have the two mixed up. There's a Marie that goes on not flirt, but she goes on help. And she's like Mexican or, you know, some form of Hispanic descent. And
she's a mod on help, right? She's a moderator. No.
I think so. I don't know. She was married to Rex before.
Rex, okay. Dude, people on Xat Help are so fucking weird. Like, I swear to God, like, I don't even find people on Flirt that weird as much as I find people on Xat Help weird. Like, I get banned. Right now, I'm banned forever on Xat Help because I just said something stupid and they just banned me literally for 0 hours. That means forever. So, I don't know if you guys go on Xat Help. It's pretty stupid as shit. Like, they don't even actually help you. Like, they're just looking for an excuse to ban you. You know, like, fuck. I don't know if you guys know Limona. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I know Limona.
I think she's a trans, as always. I don't know if you want to know about that.
Well, see, that's something else I think, too. Like, not to get off topic, but, I think that Santi chick is a fucking trans too. That she just doesn't like want to say it out loud because, you know, she might be worried, you know, there might be like any kind of judgment or, you know, people might
Andy?
Not want to be her friend.
Oh, you're talking, wait, you Sandy or Santi, the girl in the server right now?
Yeah, Santi.
Oh yeah. I Santi, I don't know. I thought she was some other chick, but I thought she was some chick named Molly, but
no, she's
I've been
really
hearing
trick.
A lot of stories of
I don't know why he thinks she's trans. She's clearly a woman.
Okay, she's a woman. Okay. What about Kitty, Apathy? Somebody said that she was trans. Do you guys think she's trans?
Kat is a woman too. All these guys are just in their feelings.
Oh, okay. Right.
If you want to talk about real tranny. If you want to talk about a real tranny, you can ask Taylor why he thinks that Darkie's pretending to be a tranny on an alt account flirting with him.
Right. Why is that? I don't know.
Well, I think it's odd that, you know, Chris at the time and probably still does, you know, Chris doesn't like me. And I was in Nisa's flirt court. And Darkie joined, and he was like, oh, I have this tranny friend you can talk to. And he was like, oh, I sent her over, like, your pictures and, like, all this other shit. So they just, like, randomly added me. And, you know, we were talking, you know, it's on and off. But, yeah, I do think it's Darkie. I think it's Darkie or Chris or maybe, like, both of them. And, like, they're just, like, trying to fuck with me.
Mm-hmm. Okay. So, Acorn, what would you do if Xolace was cheating on you with a train? Like,
I'd break up with
him. Pretty upset about that?
Yeah, it's no different to me. I'd break up with him.
Okay. Yeah, that's pretty, like, you know, if I was in your place, Acorn, and if I found out that Xolace was with a tranny, like, instead of breaking up, you have, like, an orgy or something.
Yeah, no, I'm not into that. Cheating is cheating.
I mean, you don't think that'd be hot though? Like you and Xolace and a tranny, like three way, like.
No, I'm not something new. Someone who has tits and looks like a woman. I'm good. The only women that I'd ever fuck is Kayla and May.
Kayla and May. Oh, May's a chick. Okay. Yeah, I don't know who Kayla is.
She's Kay.
May's the one.
She's in the
May's
server.
The one with the dog, right?
Yeah.
Like, yeah, she's in the server. With. She's the one with the dog. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. So, you know, it's pretty cool. Like, you know, you guys have been around for so long and you guys still manage to have a healthy relationship, not toxic. And I think that's cool as fuck because you're probably like the first couple on Xat that I've seen, like, really went that long.
Well, you know, we're not the only couple that, we're not the only couple that met from Xat, you know. I know, another couple in the server, Classy and Shady, I know they supposedly had met from Xat, and now they're together in real life. Or, you know, they'll fly each other out to go see each other like every once in a while, because I remember in Dez's server, you know, they were talking about, you know, like going out to eat and, you know, hanging out together.
Dez still has a server, like.
I left it just because, you know, anytime I'd ever go in there and talk, you know, people would just, you know, start attacking me for no reason.
Okay. Oh, how do you feel about my server? Like, you've been in my servers in the past before I deleted them. How do you like the environment and the flirt server?
Well, I don't really feel like, I feel like your server right now isn't like exactly like what you might think you would want it to be, you know, because whenever you were PCing me on Flirt, you were like, oh, I'm gonna make like a music server and, you know, just like a server to hang out, and like,
yeah.
And now you have like a bunch of people that aren't even from Xat and aren't even from Flirt that, you know, joined the server just through word of mouth, and now I kind of feel like your server is just like a, and like, I don't mean to offend anybody whenever they hear this, but I feel like your server is, you know, kind of like a toxic cesspool now of where people, you know.
Server is toxic.
I would definitely say so, dude. I mean, you know, if someone's in like one of their feelings where, you know, they don't like you on a certain day, you know, they'll just like start jumping on you and attacking you for no reason just because, you know, they don't like you today. But then tomorrow they'll like try to be your best friend.
Well, let's be real now. Why don't you call out that specific person or people that you feel like do that? Because I don't feel like I've seen that. I feel like people attack you when they call you
right
behavior. But if you're going to say something like that, drop names. Who are we talking about here?
Well, it's not just like one specific person. But I mean, if you want to give me a few names, for example, it's like, you know, you know, before Gabby became, you know, friends with May and Kayla again, you know, May was like asking me how I'm doing, like she was being friendly to me. And I mean, me and Kayla have like, we've never been, you know, friends with each other, but, you know, we were at least like cordial with each other before, you know, Gabby became friends with her again. So I feel like, you know, those two people in specific are like a little wishy-washy depending on if they like Gabby or not. And if they don't like Gabby, then like they'll be my friend. But if they're not, then they'll attack me. And you know, Mitch is, you know, I don't mean to like out Mitch either, but, you know, I mean, like me and him have a lot of conversations in main chat that should probably be happening in DM about, you know, like personal shit. And then yesterday in specific, he was like begging me almost to, you know, he like wanted me to call him out and he wanted me to, you know, he was like, oh, well then dox me and this and that. I don't even know how that came up. But then I posted his Facebook and then, you know, then he started like DMing me and then we kind of like fixed our issues with one another. So I feel like, you know, you kind of have to like be an asshole back to these people for them to like respect you or for them to, you know, be like, all right, he's not playing around. He's not playing any more games. Like, let's just chill out and be friends with each other.
Right. So what about you, Acorn? Like, is there anybody you have a problem with in the server? Like, you think they're toxic, or is there a certain person that you don't like? Okay.
I like the server. I think it has cool vibes. I think it's entertaining. I think that you need drama sometimes in order for things to not get stale. And I feel like there's people in that server that have come for me before, but I'm cool with them now. And I'm okay with that.
Who are these? Can you name them?
I mean, like just have disagreements from time to time, because Chris will call me out on shit that happens with Taylor. Same thing with Jem. And, you know, at the end of the day, I respect them both as people. I like them both as people. And I have no problems with them now. I think it's just whenever there's, like, specific issues going on, there's certain people that are more open to calling other people out on their bullshit. And you kind of have to just respect that that's their personalities. And,
you know, right.
Personally. So, like, I don't have issues. And like Taylor was saying, like, me, May, and Kayla weren't friends for a while, but like, I love them still and I welcome them back with open arms, no issues, because at the end of the day, it's Discord. And if you let it bother you too much, it affects your personal life and you can't be taking
it. Right. Absolutely. Yeah, absolutely. I agree with you. What do you think about flirt chat? Either of you guys can answer, like, the trolls and the drama and the autism on flirt. Like, because I see you troll a lot there, as always, and Acorn. I don't know if you go there.
I go in sometimes, but honestly, I think it's the same sense as Discord. I think it's, again, without the, like you said, the retards, it's not fun. And that's what makes flirt so unique, is because it attracts such a specific genre of people. And you go in there anticipating that those are the type of people you're going to interact with. And I mean, we talked in that unreleased episode about flirt a little, Altair, and I think we were kind of talking on how, like, there are some creepy people in there that do some creepy things and take things too far, and the feds are definitely watching. But outside of that, I think that flirt is exactly what everyone knows it to be, and if you're going in there, you need to expect it to be really stupid.
Right. Do you think there's, when you say creeps, like, do you think there's, like, really, like, pedos or something lurking there? And
aren't there a few people in there that have been proven to be pedophiles?
Somewhat, yeah. There's been, you know, like, who would you suspect? Like, their names? Like, would you,
like, don't they call Coke a pedophile? And there's someone else in there. I don't know their name. If you said it, I'd probably be like, oh, yeah, that's them. But, like, there's been a few people who've been, like, accused of, like, talking to girls while they're underage and stuff.
Well, I don't know about the... See, with Coke, is like, I know I'm not anyway defending him. What he has, he's basically says really fucked up shit just to get a reaction from people. Like, he'll say that, yeah, I'm pedo, I've done... You know, I've done this and that. He just wants a reaction. Although I find him annoying, I usually ignore him. I think the guy's a complete weirdo. There's this one guy. I don't know if I should drop names, but I mean, there's this one person on Flirt. He has a server, right? He has his own Xat server, and he's probably has an older server than anyone. He has like a bunch of young kids. Yeah, so what happened is, like, I went in the server a long time ago, I think Tech, and a few other people, like, you know, I know people, there's people that are cool with him, they're going to defend him, I get it. I mean, I don't hate the guy, but I went in his server, I've seen him on, you know, on the mic, and, you know, there's some underage people in that server, so I don't know if he is a pet or not. I don't know. I'm not going to say anything. You know, I'm not going to accuse anybody of anything. But it's just things I've seen, you know. Like, you know, if you're a grown man, you know, you shouldn't be talking to kids online. Like, it's just pretty creepy and weird, you know. Like, you shouldn't have a server with underage kids and you're talking to them, you know, on mic, you know. So I just thought it was weird. So, and I brought it to his attention. He just didn't care. He said they're teenagers. So I'm like, okay, all right, bro.
What's your feelings on flirt?
I've been on flirt since 08. Like when I first got there, I was a total nerd. Like I used to have a Halo chat because I used to play Halo on Halo PC. I had a Halo chat, and I used to have like a Halo website forums. I used to use like the Xat chat. Like I made my own Halo chat. I got bored. I went to fucking emo chat. From emo, I got introduced to Flirt. And then I used to hang on emo chat with Texo and Chucky and Vesus and all these fucking Leroy. And then I went to Flirt. And then I was like, I thought it was like a dating site. Because come on, the name is Flirt. You know, you're thinking it's going to be like some dating chat. And when I went on Flirt, it was the complete opposite. And I was telling Chelsea that in the last episode, like, what the fuck is this place? There was so much weird shit going on Flirt in 2008. I think that was the prime of Flirt chat. There was like 300-400 people in that chat. They had like 4 or 5 pools and people were just going nuts. Like you see people's like nudes getting exposed. People are getting doxxed and there's some fucking bestiality shit. Someone's talking about, you know, killing and murdering someone. Like, I'm like, what the fuck is this place, dude? Like, and then like I was just like new and I'm like, what is this place? I got used to it. I just started hanging out there and then I'm like, all right, fuck it. You know, there's nothing really going on. All the Xat chats died and Flirt is still alive. Like all Xat chats like that were famous, they're dead. You look at fucking emo celebrity, fucking lobby, that shit is dead. Like JB Zone is dead, but Flirt is still active. People still going on there, you know? But at the same time, I think it's pretty cool too that it's because there's some good people on there as well, and a lot of weird people and a lot of weird shit on Flirt. But I was never a troll. Like I eventually became a troll because I was around fucking trolls, and you know, yeah. I mean, Flirt is Flirt, you know. So
I have a question for Taylor. Taylor, do you consider yourself a troll? Because a lot of people think both on Xat Flirt and on Discord, a lot of your mania episodes and your fights with me and everything are just one big troll and we sit at home and we laugh about it. What's your take on that?
Well, I want to start off by saying, I'll answer the question, of course, but I want to start off by saying, you know, just to reiterate on what you guys were just talking about. I think on Flirt, you know, yeah, there is a lot of trolls, but you know, there's also a lot of, you know, genuine people on there as well. You know, like JD's genuine.
Right.
Zook is genuine, Sherm. People might not like it when I say this to, but I even think, you know, fucking Ben is a real genuine guy. And
I love Ben.
And even, you know, Wheelchair Mike, you know, I think Wheelchair Mike, I mean, you know, he gets bullied all the time. So, you know, that's why he says the N-word. And, you know, that's why Mike acts out is because, you know, people don't leave him alone. And anytime that he's ever like active in the chat, you know, people are insulting him and, you know, his family and his sisters and stuff. And
you know, Xolace, I just want to bring this up. You mentioned Wheelchair Mike, right? He's been there since like 07. So he's been there longer than me. So there's been times where I'm like, Mike, you know, hey, I'm sorry, dude. I made fun of you. I'm sorry. I apologize. Can we just be cool? And he would tell me, I hope you get raped and killed. And I hope your whole family dies. Like that's his response to me. Like he would say that openly on main chat. He would wish death and rape on me. And I'm like, okay, fuck you too, dude. I mean, I get it. You're on a wheelchair. You're getting, you know, like, come on, dude. I'm trying to be nice to you. Just want to be cool with you. You know, like the guy would say so much crazy shit to me, dude. Like, I don't know if he ever said that to you, but, and you know what, Xolace, like an Acorn, like, you know, there's some of these people on Flirt. They've been on since 07 and 08. They say the same exact shit every fucking day, like for so many years. It's just the same shit on repeat. You know, there's guys attacking Sab and it's just the same shit every fucking day you go on there. And, you know, sometimes it gets boring, you know, it's like the same old content. But I don't know, like you ever had any like, you know, have problems with people in there like Mike or somebody, you know?
Hold on. Let me answer Acorn's question first. To anyone that like that listens to this, you know, my mania, that's derived from like, you know, childhood trauma of like, you know, seeing my mom and my dad fight. And I lived with my sister and her boyfriend who she has a kid to, and I saw them like fight. And you know, I saw, you know, Gabby's mom and dad fight, you know, not to kind of out her a little bit, but, you know, growing up, like, my entire life is, like, has always been, like, a constant, you know, everyone's always fighting with one another, which is maybe why I levitated to Xat and to Discord, is because, you know, there's always fights, there's always arguments. So to anyone that, like, thinks, like, I'm, like, trolling with my bipolar and, you know, my mania episodes, it's definitely not a troll. I'm on, like, 4 or 5 different medications right now for that, bipolar specifically, and ADHD. So it's definitely not a troll. Me and Gabby aren't, when we fight, we're not trolling. You know, she may say things and I may say things that, you know, aren't necessarily true about one another, or I can't even say that, but she may say things or I may say things, and that would be our truth about the situation. And when I say that, I mean more so of, you know, for example, whenever I was talking to short name Maddie, not Gotti, but short name Maddie, you know, Gabby had said something to me a few weeks before I started talking to Maddie that was really hurtful about my mom. She told me that, go kill yourself and join your cancer-ridden mom in hell. And, you know, growing up, I was always really close to my mom. So when she said that, it really hurt me, and it made me, you know, it made me kind of like fall out of love with her. So then, you know, I met Maddie, who was kind of going through a very similar situation that I was, with, you know, her boyfriend, you know, wasn't treating her right, and was like throwing shit at her, and, you know, like cussing at her, and, while she was on mic, and like cussing and screaming at her. So then me and Maddie, that's how me and her got really close. And so anyone that ever thinks, you know, like I'm trolling with Gabby, and I know like that's Edick, Eddie in particular, he always thinks, you know, me and Acorn are, you know, trolling everybody on Discord. I mean, I wish it was a fucking troll. I really do. I wish, you know, that, you know, all my life is just like one big troll, and like I wasn't actually going through this, and whenever I turned my computer off, you know, that's where all the problems, you know, ended. But, you know, it's not like that, you know what I mean? Whenever, you know, I turn my computer off, you know, I'm still going through the same shit. Or whenever I step away from the keyboard, whenever me and Acorn are fighting, you know, I'm still dealing with those problems. And every day that, you know, I wake up, I deal with, you know, my mind working against me in a certain way. And, you know, so no, it's definitely not a troll, but it's something that, like, you know, I'm trying to work on. I quit going to therapy because, you know, my therapist would just tell me the same thing, like, oh, just go to a shelter, or, you know, I should call the cops on her. And her friends say the same thing, like, oh, you should call the cops on him. But, you know, at the end of the day, you know, it's really not that easy to, you know, just up and leave. When, you know, not only have you spent 7 years with somebody, and, you know, both of you have gone through very similar traumas in your lifetime, it's not as easy as, you know, oh, well, just leave that person because they did you wrong. You know, we also have like a shared bank account and, you know, shared credit cards, and it's really not as simple as, you know, just, you know, walking out the front door and, you know, never seeing that person again. As much as, you know, sometimes I would like it to be that easy, it really isn't. So to answer your question, Acorn, it's definitely not a troll.
Well, thank you for answering.
Okay.
And to answer
your question, that was pretty.
Hold on. To answer your question, Altair, I don't know if you asked it like word for word, but you said like, have I ever like dealt with, you know, people attacking me? The only time on Flirt that like I had the whole chat go against me was when, and you were there when it happened. was when me and Jasmine got married on Xat. When that had happened, like, I don't know if it was, you know, one of her ex-boyfriends, you know, her friends getting on Flirt and like getting on Tunes and like PCing me and like spreading false information saying, oh, you know, Jasmine's only 17 years old. Like, that's not true because she's 22 years old. And then, you know, I'd had people PC me, her, you know, pretty much without like a lack of words, like doxing her to me, like saying like all of her like past traumas and like saying like her first and last name and like her old address where she used to live to before, I guess, she moved to California. But that's like the only time like I've ever been on Flirt where it's like it wasn't like at least like a laughable or an enjoyable experience, because, you know, at that moment in time when I was talking to Jasmine, Gabby had like a whole roster of dudes that she was talking to. So she had Mitch, she had Seven, aka Jay, she had a Hinge account, Alpha, and probably a few other people that I'm forgetting about. But whenever that was going down, it wasn't like I was like cheating on her, like, you know, people try to make it out to be with, you know, me and Jasmine. It was, you know, Gabby was entertaining other dudes. And, you know, whenever I talk to somebody or like I try to move on from the relationship, it's always like I only talk to like one person, and I'm not like Gabby where, you know, I try to talk to like five or six other chicks at once to, you know, boost my self-esteem. And that was actually something me and Doc were talking about. Doc Luck, me and him were talking on VC the other night.
Yeah,
about
Doc's
that.
Cool.
And like I was talking to him about like Jasmine and the whole Maddie situation and, you know, what Gabby was doing. And he brought like a lot of like clarification from like another like man's experience through like the whole thing, because I know Doc is like he's like a no bullshit person, and he kind of just says it how it is. So I mean, I always respect, you know, Doc's opinion on those certain things. You know, Doc has been there for me whenever, you know, me and Acorn were fighting a bunch. But whenever, you know,
whenever you have somebody that,
you know, you're uncertain if, you know, when you lay your head down at night, if they're going to talk to other dudes online. I mean, it's like a worrying thing, but like, you know, you have to go to sleep, because for someone like me, like I wake up 5 to 6 times a week at 4:45 a.m. to go to work. And, you know, it's like a thing where, you know, I can't always supervise or I can't always, you know, interfere. So I feel like, you know, and this is like no disrespect to Acorn, but I feel like she's someone that, you know, she enjoys male attention and she enjoys male company. So whenever you have that, you know, it's hard to, you know, turn your back on somebody like that, if you know what I mean. And
so I only ever seek attention from other people when you're not giving it to me and you're mistreating me. And like how you talk about how I have a roster, or how like you don't think it's cheating when you're talking to Jasmine, but I have a roster of dudes. I'm normally not talking to anyone until you tell people that we're broken up. And in that same token, you're telling people we're broken up, we're not together, but you're kissing me, you're telling me you love me, you're telling me I'm your one and only, you're saying all this stuff, but then you're prancing around everyone online saying that you're single, you're not with me, that you're talking to Maddie, you're talking to Jasmine, whoever the girl is. And it makes no sense to people, because one second we're together and then the next we're not, and everyone has this confused narrative of where we stand. So, I don't know.
Well, to reiterate on what you're saying, Acorn, is that, you know, whenever, you know, I see that you're getting attention from a bunch of dudes, like, in a twisted way, it's like, I want to know that, like, you know, you still love me and you know that I'm still like your one and only, like you always tell me.
Mm-hmm.
So like, it's kind of like a reaffirmation of, okay, well, she's not completely gone yet. But then, what?
Other girl, you're saying you talk to other girls because you want me to chase you.
I wouldn't say that, no. I would say that I only talk to other girls like Annie from way back in the day, back in Mike's old chat. And whenever I talked to McSpanky's last year, whenever you were whenever you and Charlie were dating.
We never
and
dated.
Then, well, you and him, like, you were planning to, like, meet each other. And yeah, like you were asking, like you asked Charlie to like meet you like in a cabin that we had to like just recently stayed at for your birthday.
It was the year before the recent and we weren't dating. I'm just clarifying, that's all.
Or, right, you know, right.
Whenever,
so I mean, look, it's clear to me that you guys really do care for each other. I know this. I said it before. I really hope you guys, you know, you guys have a really healthy relationship and stay like this, because you guys, you know, not everybody, you know, in life gets a chance or opportunity to find true love, you know, and you guys should be, you know, very thankful for this, you know, and I mean, let me ask both of you, what advice would you give to people that haven't found someone yet? Like, what would you say to them?
My advice to them would be, you know, and this is just from my perspective, and if I could go back and do it all over again, what would I do? I personally wouldn't do it. If I could go back in time, I wouldn't do it. I would, you know, stay single, and I would just, you know, focus on myself, like, completely. And, you know, and this is just me speaking because I come from a broken family and I come from, like, you know, years of trauma and, you know, built up, like, anger and emotion towards life.
Right.
So for me personally, I wouldn't have gotten with anybody, and I would have, you know, kind of stayed single. And me and JD were talking about that earlier about, you know, how he's going to be a bachelor his whole life. And, you know, I commend him for that. Because, you know, JD, look at him. He's a happy dude. He has, like, no stress or drama. He's, you know, and you know, he has, like, a good life and a good name for himself. And I do think that if you're ever, like, trying to find love, I definitely wouldn't go on, like, Xat or Discord to find it. Because, I mean, like, whether anyone wants to admit it or not, dude, everyone on Xat and or Discord, I mean, they all have their own emotional baggage. They all have, you know, like, their own real life problems that have, you know, creeped into their online lives. Or, you know, they're just, like, downright, you know, some people are just, you know, downright fucked up individuals. So you have to, like, you have to be very, very picky and choosy about, you know, who you want to be with. And, you know, you have to know your own self-value and your own self-worth. And if you do want to be with somebody, I would always say to anybody that you have to love yourself first, and you have to love and accept who you are before you can ever be with anybody else.
Right. Absolutely. That's true. Absolutely. What about you, Acorn? What would you say? What advice would you give to people that are trying to find true love on Xat, trying to find someone, you know, they want to be with?
I'd say if you're looking on Xat specifically, that's your first problem. Someone once said to me, everyone who gets on Xat uses it explicitly to try to find a relationship. And I think, like Taylor said, it's people who have problems looking for other people that are just as bad as them, if not to boost their self-esteem, but to reassure them that they're normal. But in general, when it comes to looking for love, like, I wasn't looking for it when Taylor DM'd me or PC'd me. So I would say just continue to live your life and work on yourself. And like Taylor said, try to be the best version of yourself that you can be. That way, when the day comes that you do find that person or they find you, you're in a healthy place to be your best self for them and for yourself.
Right, right. That's pretty good advice for people in Xat. You know, that's pretty good. So listen, you know, it was really fun talking to you guys and pretty great. I really don't have anything in mind what I want to ask, you know, so, I mean, I hope we can do this again another time, you know, maybe part two, maybe individually or whatever you guys, you know, how you guys want to do it. But I really enjoyed this discussion, this podcast. You know. So, yeah, is there anything else you guys want to say? Just want to put it out there for the listeners. Well, they're all the listeners mostly are people from Xat. So is there something you just want to say and put out, like let people know about yourselves, you know?
No, just thank you for having us on.
Yeah.
I just want to say that, you know, I think a lot of people forget about this. You know, me in particular, the people that do know me, is that, you know, there is, I do have like, you know, a personality and, you know, like my own being outside of Acorn. And, you know, I kind of feel like, you know, people always say, oh, like there's nothing outside of who I am as a person than Acorn. And I also want to say to everyone on the Discord server, you know I'm the most talked about person on there. And I know, like, you know, I'm probably like one of like the most, even if I'm one of the most hated people, you know, you still have to deal with me. And, you know, you can continue talking about me. I think it's funny most of the time. Fuck you to everyone that hates me. Hope you all burn in hell. But to everyone that likes me and everyone that is my friend and someone I can depend on, and you know, they know who they are. You know, I love you, and you know, I do appreciate you.
All right, guys, you know, thank you so much for being here. Thank you so much. I appreciate both of you guys. All right, to everybody else, do check this out on zadpodcast.com. Check it on Spotify. It's going to be up there. Do share, please. Leave some feedback, react to it, leave some comments. What do you think about it? Much appreciated. Thanks, and you guys have a wonderful day. Thank you.
Thank you.
Peace out.